next big thing.
The Spice Girls really hit a nerve. It seemed like everything went right for them.
You know, if you had a room full of men, you know, every man would have a Spice Girl that they preferred.
Yeah, that's true.
I think it's very important, even if I did just get the dirty old pervert. That's fine, I've got David Beckham as well.
Exactly.
Hey, stop right now, thank you very much,
I need somebody with a... From young to old, their fans couldn't get enough of them. They copied their dance routines, learnt the songs, and bought the T-shirts.
And the main thing was like that they proved to record companies, you know, that they can invest money into girls and they can be a success.
Right from day one, people tried to change us. You know, they tried to make us have a lead singer. People did try and make us all dress the same at one point. And, you know, I mean, that's what you've got to do. You've got to be strong, you've got to know what you want to do, and you've got to go for it, you know. Don't be manipulated into doing things. At the time, the goal was there weren't any girl groups out there. You know, we wanted to be on the front cover of Smash Hits magazine, and, you know, the editor and everybody says, you know, a girl band can't be on the front of a magazine because girl bands don't sell magazines, they don't sell newspapers. So that was a real thing for us, you know. We wanted to break down that barrier, and we did.
I would say that the fans of girl bands are definitely different from the extreme fans of boy bands. They basically just like...
In 1 week, I met, like, Prince Charles, Nelson Mandela, did a safari, did a concert, and then, you know, and it's not until you sit down and think, I did all that, and you just, I mean, you know, it's just amazing.
My mum was in the bank the other day, and the lady in the bank said to my mum, oh, I haven't seen Victoria down here for a long time, what's she doing? And my mum said, oh, she's working today. And the lady said, well, you know, what's she doing? She hasn't got shows until Christmas. And people literally think that when you're a famous person, you get out of a box, you do your show, you sing your song, then you get back in your box. People don't realise that when you're writing an album, you might be working till 3, 4, 5, 6 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
You know, you do work really, really hard. So I have read complete and utter lies about myself and David and about my family and about the other girls. Complete lies. I read something the other day, I mean, it was very harmless, but I read, it's like a big exclusive, David Beckham is learning to fly falcons. Now...
Right.
Now, I mean, that was a harmless lie.
Yeah.
But it's like, David's probably doesn't even... Well, he knows what a falcon is. But it's like...
Why would he have an interest?
You know,
in
where's that
come
from?
Yeah.
You know. And that's why you cannot believe everything that you read. But people do.
Yeah.
And that's what can be helpful.
I don't.
You don't?
No.
But well, they've written horrible things about me and you as well, haven't they?
We were linked.
Yeah, we were linked.
But you went after me, exactly. And Victoria said how good I was in bed. And that's true. That bit wasn't
they
a lie.
Said I was having an affair with Andy Peters.
I know. But luckily, as you say, we're strong.
And we could cope with it.
We could cope with it.
And David didn't believe it.
David,
can't think why.
Yeah, yeah, thanks, David, mate. Mate. Because I don't wear the football shirt in bed. As I know you do sometimes.
Oh dear, Andy Peters. It's been a real battle from day one, especially media-wise. People are always there trying to knock you down. That's very hard. But it's fantastic. I mean, I'm the luckiest girl in the world. I mean, I've got an amazing family, absolutely amazing family. Husband, baby, fantastic and lovely, and a fantastic job. So I am a very lucky girl.
It's easy to forget the all-important element in all of this, the music. Wannabe, C'est La Vie, Never Ever, all great pop songs. Something that seems to get left out an awful lot these days. If you had to cite one thing as the thing that has put you where you all are today, what would it be?
Andy, that's really hard. What do you think?
Me?
Yeah.
I'd say Wannabe.
Yeah, I think Wannabe was definitely, but we had so much trouble with that song. Whereas people were saying, no, this is wrong, and we were like, no, this is so right. We could not have come out with another single. If you wanna be my lover,
you gotta get with my friend. It really showed all of our characters. It was a good, fun song. It was released in the summer. It was a summery song. It was great, and I totally agree with that. We'd have still made it if we'd have come out with a different song, but I think that was a fantastic starting point for us.
Which one I don't like?
What?
Oh, no, it's opinion. I'm allowed not to like one.
All right.
Too much.
You don't like too much?
No, I don't think I do.
Victoria's going to be very upset with you.
I like her bit in it.
That's her favourite video.
It's not, really?
Yeah.
Oh, no, that's it. I've burnt my bridge.
That's it.
Victoria will never forgive me.
Some people say that they did start a new road for girl groups.
No, not at all.
I mean, obviously, you worked with the Bananarama's.
They didn't.
Idiots. Instead, a well-rehearsed, nice routine is what the fans will enjoy.
I keep saying to them, you must calm down, because you won't be able to do your world tours with all that movement, I'm afraid. Poor things are like, oh.
You are Grand Mummy Spice, it's official. Now, you want to get yourself a blanket.
All that dancing, which is really, really great. Give you 2 years, a couple of you be pregnant, you'll all be knackered, right? You'll be a lot older. Mm-hmm. You've been doing it a long time, so calm down the dance routine. Sit on stools.
Was that, like, again, another lovely moment to think, God, there's Lulu, this big star, being me.
Absolutely amazing. And also, I didn't find out until quite near the video who was going to play me. Mm. The other girls sort of knew, but we weren't sure who was going to play me. And when Lulu turned up, I was like, I just can't believe it. And it was funny because we were doing the dance routines and she'd be watching me and taking off my moves. And I was just like, this is so freaky. Lulu is, you know, so that was fantastic.
What would your advice be?
My advice would be stick to what you believe in, stick to what you think is right, because at the end of the day, you're the artist and you're going to have to get out there and sing it. And just really enjoy yourself. I know I keep saying it, but people can see that, and it is, you know, and it's lovely to watch.
As doing solo projects, you know, the other three releasing records, you having your own TV show.
Do you find it hard to do things without having people following you, taking pictures of you and writing about you? I can't do it.
Come on, this isn't very professional, Victoria.
OK, it's not very professional. I did say I really fancied him, though, didn't I?
Everything does to everyone.
I did.
Has that strengthened or weakened, do you think, the Spice Girls?
It strengthened us in a way that, you know, if we was to just stay just as the Spice Girls and not doing anything else, we'd be suppressing each other, because obviously there are things that everybody wants to go and do. So it's made us stronger. And there aren't many bands that do that, go and do their own thing, but then they're still together as a band. We haven't got anything to prove. You know, people are saying, oh, when's the third album going to be out? When's this happening? When's the tour happening? We aren't in any rush. From day one, people have been saying that that's it and that we're finished. For us, I mean, what have we got to prove now? The album will be out when the album's out. We're all doing our own thing. Yeah. And in a way, it's made us stronger. Because you've got to be strong to do that, really. None of us are jealous of each other. You know, when I turn on the telly and I see Mel C doing her solo stuff, you know, I'm so proud of her and I love that. Mm. And it's great to all get back together because we've got so much to talk about. Yeah. We've all been, you know, completely different sides of the world. Hello, I'm Victoria Beckham. Isn't saying your name the hardest thing?
God bless you, love.